Good to see you again. What's the news? How are you getting along with the first two episodes? Are you working on understanding yourself? Shall we continue? Today we are going to analyze the reality that surrounds us. Again, prepare a piece of paper and a pen. Today's technique is called the Wheel of Life. It is used by many coaches and you may find different templates in the internet. But we can draw it ourselves. It should look like this. It's a circle with some spokes representing those areas of your life which are more important for you. Usually, this may include family, friends, hobbies, work and career, personal development, traveling, and so on. Each spoke has a scale from 1 to 10, representing the degree of person's satisfaction with this area of his life. So, our task is to select the degree of our satisfaction with each of these areas in our life. If you select 1, it means you are not satisfied with it at all. If 10, it means you are absolutely satisfied with this area of your life. And now, let's draw the lines which would connect all these points. As a rule, we'll have an uneven circle, since it's quite difficult to find a person who would have a completely balanced lifestyle. Now, let's mark the 2 or 3 areas where our satisfaction is at its maximum. These are the areas of which you have taken care of before. And now they care about you. This is the solid foundation, something you can always rely on. Our next task is to identify 2 or 3 areas where our satisfaction is at the least. That is, less than 3 to 4 points on our scale. Some psychologists who use this technique call them black holes, in the sense that no matter how much energy you apply into them, the result in the short term will be almost invisible. And this doesn't motivate. However, you mustn't ignore them entirely, but just don't throw all your power to them. The main thing is that they should not become worse. So now there are 2 or 3 areas which are left and that you are satisfied with so-so. Even the smallest application of your effort, time and money in these areas gives significant results. Therefore, I advise you to start with them. In fact, if you look at all areas of your life, even the simplest actions can improve the quality of your life by 1 point for each sector. You yourself know what to do, so make a plan and follow it. If it's not clear where to start and what to invest in, start with your health and rest. That is, invest in yourself. This will enable you to get the necessary physical and emotional resources. And while you are working on yourself, the black holes in this situation will tend to be solved miraculously on their own. This happens almost all the time, as if the efforts aimed at your strongest points increases your average performance. These standard sectors, I mean health, family, work and so on, is a good standard model, but of course you can use something of your own instead of the standard 8 areas. But again, the standard areas are a good starting point, and it's quite convenient to start with them. Well, to sum up, in order to solve the problem, first of all, it is necessary to realize that it exists. Having made some efforts, positive changes will come shortly, and the Wheel of Life will spin with a new force. So, see you in the next episode.